from Green Innovation Centers Project India. I'm Rajeshwari, gender focal point, and here is Mr. Dhananjaya.
I'm Dhananjaya from Green Innovation Center Project India.
And we are now here to answer your points, whatever you have asked from the global desk of gender.
Yeah, I will ask why is gender is a very important issue in the development cooperation?
In India, when it comes to development cooperation, gender plays a crucial role, and this refers to the gender equality or the inequality refers to the sectors like health, education, politics and economics, and where we can see the inequality between men and women. And this is very crucial because it has impacts on various other factors, like it has impacts on sex ratio, for example, it has impacts on social dimensions and education level attainments of women and other health status across the life. So in this aspect, this needs to be addressed very crucially. And though the constitution of India says there are the equal rights between men and women, but on ground we cannot see the implementation or the
equality.
And especially we can see in the informal sector, this is very prevalent in very high levels, like the wage rates are comparatively very lower compared to men and women.
In agriculture sector,
and you know better, like with the programs and those.
So let us come to the project level. So under Green Innovation Center project, how relevant is this gender issue?
Our project, the Innovation Center project, we are dealing mainly with farming community. We are working with farming community, and in all of our objectives, we have our focus mainly working on women and youth. And when it comes to agriculture sector, we can see that women are mostly confined to the less skilled jobs like harvesting, sowing, seeding, transplanting and those stuff. And when a produce moves from farm to market, the power dimensions changes. From women, it moves to men. And mainly with the decision taking
from marketing onwards.
So the lot of disparities are observed in agriculture sector, for example.
So can you tell any good example of your intervention where we can bridge that gap?
This is a very important question. Like in our project, since the stage of conceptualization and program planning, we have ensured that gender takes a prominent place. In all of our objectives, for example, to quote some of the objectives, we are aiming to train like 90,000 of farmers, and there must be, like, the target must be 35% of women must be covered. And not just that, also with creating employment, increasing income, farm income, everywhere we have this target of women, the gender marker should be achieved. And not just that, to tell a brief introduction of our project itself, we will work on this basic theme of 4G. 4G, as you know, it is the fast...
Telecom sector,
the acronym used for faster, reliable data transfer. So we have taken that acronym for our project, and this 4G stands for, first one is the, it stands for green project. Ours is a green project, it's a German project, and it is a
global
program working in 13 countries, and the 4G indicator is a gender. So we ensure that why this acronym is needed, we ensure it as a checklist. Like before planning any interventions, we ensure that all these 4Gs are met.
Okay.
So, and we are working with this approach. And to quote an example, in our project size, we have already achieved up to nearly 11 farmer study groups, all women's farmer study groups.
Okay.
So we have all members are women, and they are taking the lead of all the activities conducted under the FSGs.
So you are ensuring their active participation,
yes.
in decision making, and also
we have enabled them, we have supported them, we have capacity built them too,
and also you have lent some financial assistance also. by linking with the
financial aid to the women farmers. Yes, exactly. And to quote a particular example, we have this farm woman called Lakshmi from Madanpally area of Andhra Pradesh state. She is very, very innovative farmer. She is a farmer who is practicing organic, sustainable methods to grow our vegetables. And after we came to know, identified her under our project initiatives, we, you know, in Madanpally, the tomato market was mainly male dominated. Majority of the operations in market are handled by men. So we supported her to get access to this male dominated market. And today she is like a very successful farmer, a good example for her fellow farm women, and she is leading self-help groups, also women self-help groups. And not just that, she is also producing organic products by herself, and we are helping her with the marketing and planning business models for her innovative entrepreneurship.
So are you doing anything specifically for the project staff to sensitize or to strategize on gender issue?
Yeah, this is also a very important point. Actually, our partners are well in different levels when we collaborated with them. So some of them were already very good with even inclusion strategies. Some of them were lagging behind. So we now and then conducting a lot of sensitizing workshops. Next month we are having one such workshop for the partner staff.
Partners to capacitate lens of gender.
To have the gender dimension from grassroots level. So we ensure that now and then all the staff are capacitated.
So with this, we also will develop one strategy for the Green Innovation Project on gender issue.
Yes, for sure.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.